Hey everybody, thought I'd do a little collection update video in HD quality because the last three showing all the vacs, or most of them, at my house here in the basement were on my regular camera before I got the HD video capable laptop. So now I figured since all my videos since using the laptop are with the laptop in HD, I figured I'd just reshow the collection in better quality. Since I know the last ones were with my work light and my crappy camera, and even I think it's annoying, so yeah, the quality was just horrible. So I'm just going to give a run through of all the vacs, which I think, I'll bet most of these vacs have been shown in their own videos, and of course in the three videos showing the collection. So starting on the corner here is my coat rack, the Dirt Devil Deluxe. Usually where I throw my coats, as you can see, when I come down here to what I call my office, which is my section here with the wood floor and the carpet behind it, and where I put all my vacuums and my desk. And next to that, and bear with me on the camera work here, as my head was just in there, as I try to orient the vacuums looking at the camera upside down. So second to that, on the corner here, see pretty much Hoovers and Dirt Devils here. Well, this is actually the leftover Hoovers. The other Hoovers are in the corner. But anyway, first here we have the Futura. This is basically the exact same thing as the Dimension next to it, except it has the full Type A bag with the hose and tools, or hose on the side, tools in the back. I don't have any of the tools, and I'm still missing the height adjuster lever thing. This vac does have the upgraded 20-bladed fan, and as I have said before, it does make a difference in sound quality and power. And then, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that vac besides needing a cord when I got it. And next to that, as I said, is the Dimension. Just standard Dimension, no special edition or whatever they have. I think the only thing wrong with this vac was it was missing the hose, and the motor mount was busted, which of course I replaced the motor mount and waited till the vac store got a used hose, and I bought that a long time ago, like when I got this thing. This was my upstairs vac, which I switched like back and forth like 10 times on what vac I wanted upstairs. Now I finally settled with the Phantom and the Rainbow. And next to that is my Breathe Easy, which I believe I brought this in the house not long before I took all the vacs out of my friend's garage and put them in storage. There was absolutely nothing. This vacuum is in excellent condition, minus a couple rips on the crappy soft guard bumper, and it was severely clogged with carpet fibers. Other than that, it had a brand new bag and belt, and all the attachments are there. Brush is in excellent condition. Works nicely. That is a 12 amp, if you didn't know. And next to that, we have the three feather lights. First one here, they've all been in videos. These two have been the only ones running because I don't really like running the green one. Don't need to give info on that. You can watch the video on those. There's the green one. And let's see here. Watch what I'm doing. I'll just turn around. And then here on the corner, we have the, what's that? The Boss 4D and my nicest Vision upright. And on the corner here, other corner, I don't know if I'm getting them in there, we have the DS-80 in the front there. Behind that we have the DS-50, and then behind that the Santronic 7. And I'll go up and over so you can see everything on top. Let's see here, am I getting it? There we go. Alright, next to the Dirt Devil here, which is on the end, we have the Bravo 2, set the 7.2 amp. That one still has some iffy motor issues. Behind that, I'm going to put my hand like on the handle so you know what I'm talking about. This one right here is the Whirlwind Light. Another one of the Eurekas that has built-in self-propel because the brush roll is that good. And in the line here, we have the Whirlwind Light, the Powerline Limited Edition, I believe. Yep, and then of course the Dirt Devil. And next row over, where are we at? This row right there. Yep, right there. I'm holding the Powerline Plus, which has motor issues last I checked. One of my favorites, the Bravo 8.5 85th anniversary, or a Boss, Bravo, whatever you want to call it. Wind tunnel bagless, the number two, the one with the dirt sensor, and the other one is in storage and doesn't work very good. Next to that, we have my Easy Light, one of my oldest vacuums here in the basement. The Boss Special Edition Y-Track with the weird hose assembly setup thingy on it. Also, my hat rack, the Excalibur. Definitely know that one's got a video. And over here, we start pretty much the Hoovers. We have my Power Max with my added electronic speed control from a Concept 2. We have my, see, seen it? Yep, we have my Power Partner, which I bought from my Vac Buddy. My pristine condition runabout deluxe. So it showed the Breeze, the Elite 6.0, Elite 5.0, runabout, what's that? No, it's not runabout. Encore Supreme. The Elite, I always forget the name of this one. No, this is the runabout. I don't even know my own vacuums. And this is the runabout. We have the two soften lights in the back there. The Elite, whatever this one is, what's this one? Elite soften light. And my two Phantom Thunders, the 11 and 12 amp. And my green and red feather light baglesses in the back there along the wall. So you see, I don't really pay attention to my vacuums much, and sometimes I forget what I own. As I think I said, I did that once. I was looking at my list of vacs and said, I own one of those, and I was running through the, I was looking at all the vacuums in the basement trying to find it, and I finally found her hidden in a corner behind a bunch of clothes. I'm like, oh, I didn't even remember I owned that vac. And over here, we have the Elite Hoover Collection, not the Elite Vacuum, the Elite section of the concept on the corner. Am I showing you here? The convertible on the corner. Dial-O-Matic next to that. My 1989 concept one, I believe. Unplated, whatever concept that one is. My newest collection edition, the Concept 2. And behind that, if you can see it, the Rainbow D3. And attachment collection starts here with the Santatronic 7's attachments and the DS50's attachments and my Eureka Steamer's attachments on top of that. And next to that, if you can see, is the attachments for the original Rainbow. And here we have the Dirt Devil and Bissell collection, or cheap Dirt Devil and Bissell collection. My three oldest swivel glides. There's the dark red one, which is the Ultra or whatever. The Ultra, the green one, which is my oldest one in my collection, not the oldest one. And my red one, whatever that one is. And of course my light, which is a YouTube favorite. And Power Force Black, number one of three Power Forces, one of two black ones. Bissell Clean View. Original Clean View. Well, not the original. The original was the light blue one. Just regular black one. I had two of these. I gave the other one to my neighbor. All my other attachments, the Handy Butler for the Santronic 7. Kenmore Power Mate that I got for free off Craigslist. Vacuum Flow Rugrat that went to my dad's central vac. It got replaced when he bought all new hose and crap like that. My vast array of attachment or hoses and turbo nozzles. I have more turbo nozzles than that. That's just all I have the room for. Brush plates. Carpet steamer wands, which don't really do any good because they're in storage. Also the wands for the rainbows. Bissell and Singer stick vacs. The Eureka stick vac. The Powerline Super Broom, Dirt Devil Dynamite, Bissell Easy Vac, bag for a Kirby something back there. Behind the bag, there, that's the Shark Transformer. I have my some type of roto blade sweeper standing up there if you see the silver handle. Hoover Shampooer and the Shark retractor that likes to fall apart, and of course Rexair hoses. And the Enviro steamer, which I mentioned before. And let's see here. Yeah, there's vacs over there, but I'm not going to try to show you them between the all the clothes hanging up. That's where I found the missing vac. That's where I have all the power nozzles. The kind of more upright, if you saw it there. Hanging in the corner is the Dirt Devil Roommate, whatever. I keep forgetting the name of that thing. Touch-up. My Panasonic vacs are over there. My two Kenmore vacs. Over in the bag over there is the EuroPro hand vac. I bought off HSN a long time ago. I think that's pretty much it. There's the handy vac, which I showed. Kirby hoses and a Hoover convertible hose there. My small assortment of vac bags and crap. Which I haven't really needed lately. I used to buy vac bags a lot, but now that I don't really pay much attention to the vacuums, they don't need much changing. So, I guess there's not much to say about that. And the Hoover shop vac, my most used machine here if I ever use a vacuum. So, hope you enjoyed the little update of all the vacs here in my office, aka the basement. And always look forward to more requests.